This is a quick start video tutorial for the Flipink app, which is the app that I started doing sketchnotes with. It also is an app that I use a lot with students. It is a paid app. Last time I checked, it was only $1.99. When you open up the interface, it has one notebook, and you can add a variety of notebooks in and label them, so it's nice for organizing your sketchnotes. This one right here is something that it comes with in the app already, including this nifty drawing showing all the tools that are available in the app and an example of a drawing. To add another page in the notebook, like most apps, you're simply going to touch the plus and it will add a blank page, and then simply take your fingers and pinch it open. The tools run along the bottom and they're pretty intuitive. You have a pencil tool, a crayon that's nice and grainy. You have an ink tool that has a little bit of a swoop in it if you draw fast. You have a marker tool that has a little bit of a dot at the beginning and the end of your drawings when you draw fast. And then you have a thicker marker, and you also have a watercolor pen, which has some neat transparency. And then of course over here is your eraser. The colors are along the bottom. There are just some basic colors that you can use. It also has, if you touch on this little, these two little double lines, will expand the color palette and has a few more basic colors that are already preset. And then if you want to customize colors, if you go into this circle here, this opens up a whole color wheel where you can absolutely pick any color that you want to draw with, which is helpful and fun. And you also can use this eyedropper. So if you want to match a color that's already on your screen, you can do that as well. And then you can close down your colors again by tapping these little double lines. These right here will customize the thickness of your line and will also customize how transparent your line is. And I do like having those controls available. Some apps don't let you customize, but I really like to be able to do that a little bit. It also has over here, if you tap on the little circle at the bottom, it will hide the tools so that you can draw underneath, and then you can just pop them open again. The plus right here opens up some other features for you. So this tool right here will let you put lines or a grid in your background. I'm a big fan of using a grid because it helps you to be able to see how big and how small you are working and writing. And especially when you're zooming in and out, it also helps you with positioning if you have a grid. This tool will let you take a picture from your camera, and this one lets you insert a picture from your camera roll, which is pretty nifty. Once the picture is in, you can, oops, I didn't want to do that. Let me tap it again. I can take the corners and resize it. I can move it. I can rotate it. And then if I go over down here, there's a bunch of other customizing features, including some different kinds of frames that I can add to it. And right now the frame is white, but if I want to change it to a colored frame, I could do that. I also can set whether it's going to be in the foreground or in the background, and the background will allow you to draw over top of it. You can lock it. And you can also delete the picture if you want. So to add text, you go to this little tool right here that looks like a speech bubble, and a text box will pop up. If you double tap on it, the keyboard will come up, and that will allow you to type on the keyboard. And then when you hide the keyboard, you have a bunch of other options, including changing your color, your bold, your alignment. If you also tap right down here in the bottom left corner, that's going to open up your sizing and also gives you all kinds of options for fonts, depending on what kinds of fonts you have installed on your iPad. And like I said, a lot of students really do like to use text by typing rather than by writing text. And so I think it's a good option to have that available for students to use. Another helpful tool when you go down here to the red plus is an undo tool. And I'm going to have to go back to get out of my typing and go to my drawing tools, and I'm going to draw something. And now if I hit this plus, there's a little arrow here that lets me undo and redo. There also is another way that is a two-finger gesture that allows you to kind of slide back and forth. You get this slider up at the top. I find it to be a little bit fussy, but some people like using that way of undoing. When you are done with doing your picture, you simply have to pinch it to save it. And then you do have options down here. So if I touch on the little box with the arrow, it gives me the option to save it to the photo album. So that's a quick look at the Flipink app. I hope that you will enjoy using it for making sketch notes and drawings.